Hey guys, welcome to another Grawrz guide. In this video, I'm going to talk about the mechanic change job quest, how to equip the MadoGear, and which monster I'm farming for job experience. Now, without further ado, let's get on with the guide. First things first, your character has to be job 70 to trigger this quest. The quest marker will lead you into the adventure HQ in Prontera, and it will have to talk to Gunther to trigger the quest. Gunther will tell you about the mechanics guild in Juno, and he will tell you to pass their tests. To get to Juno, you have to cross north of Aldebaran. Now I'm going to show this clip, but speed it up because I don't want to bore you with the walking around part. This is the border checkpoint map. Just keep heading north to get to the Einbroch Field. This is the Einbroch Field map. To the left is the Magma Dungeon, and to the north is the Juno City. And I saw the Archangeling, so of course I have to take a picture because it's a new map and it's the first time I've seen it. And I have to take a picture of the other monsters too. It's a good idea to do this too, guys, because you can see the stats of the monsters in your adventurer's book. And finally, we arrive at Juno, and we are treated to a cinematic view of the city. Let's enjoy this clip, guys. That was a nice view of the city, but it might have been better if it was daytime. Alright, so our purpose here in the city is to head north and talk to Mohard. Mohard is the vice leader of the Mechanics Guild, and he will trigger the change job quest. Now, after all this talking, he will ask for items. The required items are 200 Cyfars, 200 Box Wrappers, and 424,000 zenny. After you've collected all of the items, you have to turn it in one by one. So I handed it in the 200 Cyfars, then I handed in the 200 Box Wrappers, and lastly I handed in the 424,000 zenny that he asked for. Now after you've done all of that, he will ask you to proceed with the change job quest. You will have to talk to Sullivan. Sullivan is found at the entrance of Juno City, so let's head on over to there now. Sullivan will then give us three places to go to: the Glass Time Culverts, Toy Factory 2F, and Pyramid 2F. You don't have to worry about the location he's talking about because there are quest markers there. So let's head on over to Culverts now. Once you get to GH Culverts, just go to the quest marker and then flip the switch. Once inside, you will be transported to the Valkyrie Castle, wherein you will have to kill all of the monsters inside. This should be pretty straightforward, so I'll just fast forward the clip. When all the monsters get defeated, you get rewarded with the body of a mech. Now that's 1 out of 3 pieces done. Let's head on over to the second stop, which is Toy Factory 2F. In Toy Factory 2F, just head on left to the 9 o'clock position, and then we will be transported to the inverted end of the Valhalla ruins. Once again, all you have to do is defeat all the monsters. When all of the enemies are defeated, we get rewarded with the head of a mech. So that's 2 out of 3 pieces. Let's head on over to Pyramid 2F, flip the switch at the right side, and we will be transported to this map. I think this is Valkyrie, or the second floor of the Valkyrie castle. And once again, we have to defeat all of the monsters in this map. This time we are rewarded with the limbs of a mech, and now we have the head, the body, and the limbs. We have all the pieces, so let's head on back to Juno and talk to Sullivan. Sullivan will be happy that we have all 3 pieces, and then afterwards he will ask for 2 time twisters. I hope you guys prepared it beforehand because time twisters are pretty expensive. As of this video recording, time twisters are 678k. So yeah, it's pretty expensive, but I think it's worth it. Once you turn the time twisters in, you will be asked to go back to your Mohard. Go back inside the city, head on north, talk to Mohard, and Mohard will then teleport us to the job change ceremony. Congratulations, you are now a mechanic! That ends the first part of this video. Next, I'm gonna show you how to ride the MadoGear, because it's not exactly straightforward. Alright, so how to get the MadoGear, you first have to buy it from this NPC at the lower left of Prontera. He is going to talk about getting a lot of items, but it's actually, you just have to pay 1.28 million to him. Yep, so after all that talking, just pay him 1.28 million and he will give you the MadoGear item. The MadoGear item goes into the mount slot. There you go, add the mount slot. And then it won't actually give you the mecha yet. You have to use the MadoGear license skill. And there you have it, that's how you use the MadoGear. The last part of this video is I'm going to show you which monster I'm farming for job experience. As you can see, I'm farming cookies, and this is because cookies are level 108 and my character is only base level 100. You have to be within 10 levels of the monster you are farming to get the maximum amount of loot and experience. As for the runes, you can see that I removed most of the cart related skills, and this is because I need those medals for the knuckle boost runes. The knuckle boost runes cost 30 gold medals each, so yeah, that's pretty expensive. So I had to sacrifice some of my older runes. The cart runes are useless now, so I removed all of them. So this is the first knuckle boost rune, It is to the left of the Cart Revolution rune, which you should be familiar with if you've farmed with Cart Revolution before. And this is the second Knuckle Boost rune. This is the third. This is the fourth rune. And the fifth rune I don't have enough medals for yet. And it's located at the very bottom. As for the skills, I have level 2 MadoGear license. The higher the level of your MadoGear license, the faster you move. And I have level 5 Knuckle Boost because this is the skill that I will use for farming. You can see that I have plus 40% Knuckle Boost damage from the runes. Since I'm back to grinding mode, I started using my Saint Gear again. And I started using the Orb Doll Hat and the Dusk Veil. These items give us bonus experience, so it's a good idea to use them. As for my other gear, I'm gonna show them to you, but it's not really that much different from what I've been using for farming before. I've been getting a lot of requests for guides, and unfortunately this is new for me, but don't worry guys, once I get enough knowledge about mechanics, I will make guides for them. And that's it for this video guys, I hope you learned something, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!